life dedicated to country. Joining us now is Newsmax analyst Craig Shirley, also a Reagan biographer and presidential historian. Craig, thank you so much for coming on. Good to talk to you again.
You bet, Rob. Thank you very much.
So Rumsfeld, you know, was a big name, big figure throughout, you know, decades in politics, a transformational career. Not only did he serve as defense secretary twice in those two non-consecutive terms, he was a White House counselor under Nixon, served as Reagan's special envoy to the Middle East. Tell us more about this guy. Had a big career.
Yes, yeah. He was also a NATO ambassador, but of course, going back to the 1950s, he was a Navy veteran and a Navy pilot in the 1950s. So he had a long, distinguished career of servicing his country, both in uniform. In fact, on September 1st, 2001, after the airline crashed into the Pentagon, he was he was a defense secretary at the time. And was actually hauling bodies out of the Pentagon, even at his advanced age. And his position at the time. So it was an honorable man for many years. It was a lot of, you know, always some controversy attached to him, but he probably was probably the second most consequential defense secretary in our lifetime.
Right. Yeah. I mean, he has been criticized over, of course, the length of the Iraq War, also the weapons of mass destruction. Everybody remembers that from Bush too. Here's what Rumsfeld said in an interview about 10 years ago.
I also said and believe that no one can estimate the length of something like this, or the number of people that will be involved, or the cost. You can't predict that. If you compare it with the Cold War, and it's much more like the Cold War, which lasted decades.
You know, liberals might say he was a bit of a warmonger. Would that have been a fair criticism?
Well, no, not a warmonger, but he certainly was an internationalist. And, of course, we live in a very dangerous world. He recognized that, and especially after September 11th, 2001, terrorism is all around us. And, of course, that's why the war in Iraq was conducted, the war in the Middle East was conducted under his stewardship. There was some criticism of that on the left and the right, but he did, and George Bush did what they thought was right.
Yeah, absolutely. All right. Craig Shirley, Reagan biographer and presidential historian. Sir, thank you so much for the time.
You bet, Rob. Thank you very much.
All right. Coming up, the Trump Organization and one of its chief executives have been indicted.